In this week's parasha, Parashas Vayishlach, we have the story of where Yaakov is fighting with the Malach. And it says in the Pasuk, Vayar kilo yochol lo. The Malach could not conquer Yaakov. He couldn't overcome him. Vayiga bekaf yerecha. But he touched him in his hip. Vatiga bekaf yerech Yaakov. Beofke imai. When he fought with him. So, at the end, the only damage the Malach could do to Yaakov was hitting him in the thigh and damaging him. The Ramban says, there's a very interesting Ramban here. The Ramban says that the Malach didn't have permission to do any more damage to Yaakov other than to hit him in the Geranosha. And then he brings a Medrash. And he says a Medrash like this. It says in the Medrash that he was able to affect Yaakov Avinu in the tzaddikim of later generations. And the Kaf Yerech Yaakov refers to further generations. And he says that there will be a time in the Dor Shel Shmat when Esav will overwhelm Yaakov, overtake Eretz Yisrael, and begin a period of Shmat. This was in the times of Mishnayis, of Yehuda ben Borva, the Chaver. And it says the following, it says the beautiful Medrash. Medrash says as follows. Omer Rabbi Akiva bar Abba, if a person would tell me, give up your life for Kiddush Hashem, I would do it right away. No problem. But, ubevachi huguni miyad, avu bedor shel shmad, ein yochel lizbol. Had I lived in the door of Shmad, I wouldn't be oimid ben Yisrael. And the Ramban says, the Medrash says, what did they do in the door of Shmad? They took balls of iron, they put it under the arms of the victims, the Jewish victims, and that's how they died, through suffering. So Rabbi Chiya bar Abba said, had they killed me on the spot, I would be oimid ben Yisrael. But to survive torture, that I couldn't do. Zog Ramban, v'yesh doros achirim, and that in history, there have been other generations besides the one mentioned in the Medrash. Also, in one of Esav, Kozev, Yosef, Ramizeh, they did worse things to us, and everything we suffered. And still, we survived. Kemosh Ramaz, Vayova Yaakov Shom. Now, this is a very interesting Medrash. Why does Rabbi Chiya bar Abba say that had I been in the Dor Shmad, I wouldn't have been Oymid ben Yisrael? Now, the people in Dor Shel Shmad were Oymid ben Yisrael. So why do you think he couldn't do it? What's the pshat? Was he any less than everybody? So you see from over here the following, that we don't know what koyches we have. Either because koyches are given to us from the office, we have certain latent koyches given to us from our forefathers and previous generations. We don't even realize we have it. There's an interesting Gemara in Gittin. The Gemara says in Gittin, by Chana v'Shiva Banero, she told her last son, when you go up to Shemayim and you'll see Avram Avinu, tell him, you sacrificed one child for HaKadosh Baruch Hu, I sacrificed seven. Now what is the meaning of this? Was Chana trying to brag? Was she trying to tell Avram Avinu she is greater than him? But I think the pshat's the other way around. She was trying to tell him, you know where I had the power and the ability to sacrifice seven kids on Kiddush Hashem? I got it from you. So that's one union. We don't know the koyches that we have that is latent within us from our office. And in second pshat, I would say the following. We never know what koiches we have till we get there. Ilu, if I would live in the Dor Shel Shmad, with the koiches I see in myself today, I wouldn't be Oymid ben Yisrael. But when the Rebbeinu Shalom puts you in such a place, you'd be surprised what koiches the Rebbeinu Shalom gives you when you're there. With the Nisayon comes the koiches. If the Rebbeinu Shalom tells us, to finish Shas, to do everything you have to do. You should know that not only did Rabbi Yishon say you have to do it, but the Rabbi Yishon is also telling us you have the courage to do it. If you should do it, you could do it, you will do it. Good Shabbos.